What's up, fellow classers? It's Apollyon here, bringing you to the end of our war versus Jarno's knights, a level 6 clan versus us as a level 5 clan. This is our, I think, 49th win in a row. We're undefeated, so, you can see kind of what they did, 105 to 50. We did get a perfect war. It's pretty awesome. Just to show you kind of what we did, we didn't even use all of our attacks. I think we used 58 of 70, 35 3 stars to their 23 2 stars, and 4 1 star attacks. Used a lot of mass dragon, go wipe, and a couple variations here and there of different types of attacks, but a lot of 2 star attacks. We'll go ahead and check some of these things out. We'll look at the Town Hall 9s on this video, and then I'll make another one of our Town Hall 8s. Their bases, I don't even remember if they were really, I think they were pretty, not really, really rushed, but still another rushed clan base. And I think we did get the clan castles filled on their side, so that's always a plus. So anyway, let's jump into this thing, including a live attack that I have here. We'll watch our number one Langbang take out their number one and their number two. He's going to use Mass Hog with dragons in there, so he'll bring Freeze. And Lang is a Town Hall 9, so he's going to bring a Freeze, a Rage, and 2 heals. Go ahead and do that lure. They do have their clan castle filled with their royals, put all the way on the outside for easy pickings, which is just crazy. Let's fast forward this as he uses, I think he uses 2 poisons. Yes, he does. And gets rid of their clan castle that way, and it's time to start the raid. Do a quick queen swap there. Couple breaths, 3 breaths from the dragon, that queen goes down. A little bit more from the other one to take the king down, so he does basically suicide dragons, and then this Azen walls the hogs in there. He's got to get through 2 infernos, so he will bring that freeze in there for those infernos. He'll rage them up, and then it's time to freeze them up. He doesn't get both of them, and it is set to single inferno, so those hogs are going to make it all the way there and go ahead and take care of that one. He does have another heal left. These hogs make it all the way through. Finally drops in his royals to start basically the cleanup and lets the hogs do all the dirty work. And we're just about finished here. Very quick raid. And we'll fast forward it as he pretty much crushes this base. So very nicely done. And, way to start this thing off. And since that attack was so good, we'll go ahead and check Lang also take out their number 2. Again, Town Hall 10 rushed with, there's one Inferno. I think it's a single. I don't know. I'm not sure how to tell. I'm sure somebody will tell me how to tell. But anyway, he brings a shattered entrance with 2 golems, do some wall breakers to get all the way to those 2 compartments. Doesn't get the complete break on the second one. So he'll use the jump spell, drops his king in there, and some giants to go ahead and start tanking and helping out. Hasn't dropped the queen yet, as far as I can see. But the dragon does come out of the clan castle, drops a poison down there, and then starts to send the hogs in on the back end as the other kill squads make it in from the exact opposite side. So they'll trigger some giant bombs in the core. Hogs are making it through with a heal, has a rage and another heal, so he'll go ahead and rage those hogs, get them into that inferno. I think it is a single inferno again that will roast each hog one by one, but not quick enough as those hogs will make it through. Some hogs go flying, but that's already still has another heal. He'll go ahead and use that heal. Pretty weird. I don't know if that I missed the giant bomb or something, but just probably not the best heal there. That would have been a better heal right there. But it takes care of that last defense. Oh, the queen will take care of that last defense. And the hogs will go redirect and start the cleanup. Giants are walking around banging on walls trying to catch up to the hogs. They never will. We'll just continue this cleanup here. So very, very nice 6-star war for Lang, taking out their top 2 bases. Very cool, very cool. Lang's getting tons of practice on Town Hall 10s, unfortunately. He's going to be like an expert when he gets to Town Hall 10 and taking these things out. Even though they are rushed, still taking out these infernos like nobody's business. Let's go to Ebon, our number 11, hitting all the way up to number 3. Pretty heavy defenses. I think this is almost a max Town Hall 9 as far as defenses go. Obviously not as far as walls go. But that's fine. It's still a tough base, and Ebon is an 8.5. Low Royals, only level 5 Hogs, not even level 6 Loon there. So go ahead and drop the Shattered Entry with a jump there to redirect these Golems. Queen's in there, drops the Poison for the Clan Castle, brings a Stone Entrance with another Golem in there to continue to push these Kill Squad through that core. And he does have Hogs and one Loon for a back end. So he's going to take out that Expo, send the Loon in for an easy trade-off right there for that one cannon. And kind of, to get them funneled in. And semi-tank for the Hog. I think the Queen's still up, walking around, but I don't think she's going to be up for too much longer. That Golem is tanking for her for the Expo. The Hogs are kind of coming in untouched. At least that Expo is not giving them any problems. We'll go ahead and lay that heal down there for that Giant Bomb. And the Quad Tesla Farm, Max Teslas. Queen will use her ability while the Hogs are making their way around. Another heal used, and still one more heal left, which is going to be no problem to push through the rest of this base. There's hardly any defenses left. That Queen will remain up and be part of the cleanup process, which is going on as we speak. So, very common, I think, Town Hall 9 internet base there. But, nonetheless, not a simple one to beat for an 8.5. Queen hits a double Giant Bombs there, I guess, and but barely makes it out. But very nice attack by Ebon. All right, Huckles going in on number 4 versus 4 with a weird, I guess, like fish design or maybe a plane. I don't know what it is. A bird or plane, or it's Super Huckles, and he's gonna go ahead and trip that Giant Bomb. Trip another Giant Bomb while grabbing the lure. Use that poison. I don't think he grabbed the dragon in on that poison, if I'm not mistaken. I guess he did. I could see the little emote and the animation there. Alright, so that Golem's going to go ahead and just walk and bang into that wall head first. Same with the other one, and start tanking. Drops a lot of whiz to help create that funnel. He's going to do a P.E.K.K.A. with Hogs, along with his Royals. We'll use that jump in there. And I think I might have used a couple Wall Breakers again in that first compartment, and then use the jump to get like all the way into the core. But, whatever. It's no big deal. So the Royals are knocking things down. The Queen's in there. King's in there. P.E.K.K.A.'s in there. She's doing damage. That Wizard gets taken out, and it's time to go ahead and trip that Giant Bomb up top. Trip another Giant Bomb up top. I thought this was a cleanup attack, but I don't think he would have sent the Hogs in like that if it was. But whatever. It's very interesting. So he has 9 more Hogs after this with 2 more heals left. Those kill squads making it all the way throughout the core. So really just got to worry about some of those Expos and a couple other things in there. Still has one more heal left. Those Hogs doing damage on the bottom. The other Hogs will meet up with them right now. And I think that's almost a max cannon, isn't it, for Town Hall 10. Wow. So still one more heal left. Those Hogs are going to make it through there here, no problem pushing through. Does have to use that heal though soon, just because that... Archer Tower is doing damage. That Expo is completely locked on the Golem, so those Hogs will hit that untouched. P.E.K.K.A., she's walking around looking for things to hit. Queen's doing her thing on the top. Everybody's got a good split. That King is knocked out, so he'll be doing nothing. But a very, very nice attack by Huckles against get that 3-star. Alright, this one gave us, I think, a little bit of a problem. I don't know why. I think we're just, again, it's the motivation there. We were completely destroying this clan, so. He's going to bring a La Loon here. I'm not sure. Yeah, he doesn't bring a Shattered. He brings a Shattered in here. Goes and splits his Golems. Has a couple of Wall Breakers, which will go in there. Boom, one. This sends another one in there. Boom, it will open it up completely. There we go. Golem will redirect, sends the king and queen in there. Go ahead and take care of that clan castle, which is just a wizard, archer, and a dragon. And Tesla pops in there, Max Tesla. The poison is dropped in there, which will take care of everything but the dragon. The wizard's on top of it, so is the queen. Take it down. And now that that queen is down, it is time to start sending in the loons. And he's going to deploy, the hounds. And he's going to go ahead and deploy them from the bottom as that last, the first air defense goes down. So the enemy queen is down, and the one of the air defenses is down. So it's time to go ahead and start sending in those hounds. Starts send them in from the bottom right and sends the loons in there. He has four rages to get those loons all the way towards that air defense. So they're raged up and making their way through. Another Tesla pops. The first lava hound pops there. The pups are helping out. The second lava hound pops. And then he sends the last lava hound from the top. It needs to take out both of those air defenses that... finally, it will not go down. It will go down right here, and there is no more lava hounds left, so those loons have to do the work. They're almost there, though, as far as that air defense. They are raged, and they'll make it right here and take it out, and now all they have to do is worry about that archer tower and Tesla. Nice, not tons of pups, but a nice split on those pups, which are cleaning out the other parts of the base. The loons will get that Tesla down. Not a lot of loons left. I think three left, but that's fine because there's plenty of pups to go help out with that cleanup, and not too much left of the base to clean up. So very, very nice attack, Brando. I think that was like our fourth hit on that base. Just again, I don't know why. It wasn't a very, very tough design, but a lot of the defenses were maxed. Besides the air defenses, they were not. Alright, number 6, we are going to skip that. In fact, we're not going to skip it. I'll go ahead and put the live attack in there right here. Alright, so nice attack by Zito there. And let's see E-Ball and get his 6-star war here on their number 6. No, I can't count. Number 7. And he's going to use a GoHo here. He's going to bring a stone entrance, so he brings a golem in the clan castle, and he's bringing two golems of his own. Get that nice wide the split there using the wizards to go ahead and funnel. Drops the poison for that clan castle. Wall breaker does go in, test wall breaker. The other wall breakers will go just randomly and start blowing up stuff, because that's what they do. Sends the last golem in there as well. I think he wants to make a pretty decent push in here, as one of those golems will split into golemites, that max one. Queen locks on the other queen, and guess who wins on that battle? That'll be the friendly queen. King's just smashing stuff. Uses a jump spell to reroute everything into that core, starts tanking for that expo. Queen takes out the air defense, and it's time to go ahead and start sprinkling the surgical hogs. They'll make their way through this base, has three heals after he's used that jump. So there's the first heal that's placed in there. Still has 13 hogs left, and I'll start to sprinkle some more hogs in to meet up with that initial deployment of hogs. Both royals are still up, and still has 10 more hogs to feed in. And use that heal. It's probably a good time to drop some more of those hogs in there. And then uses the last bit of hogs on the bottom and bottom right. Eats that giant bomb, no big deal. Still has another heal left, which he can use right here. Triggers the double giant bomb set one at a time. So that's just perfect. And they'll start to pound on that enemy king, take him down. And it's all over for right now. Both other friendly royals are up, starting to clean out around the base. The queen will decide to shoot into that pesky wall. And then shoot into another pesky wall, and they'll all meet up for some drinks afterwards and talk about it. Alright, number 8. Don't know who this is, but obviously he can get a 3 star. So we'll watch Apollyon take out their number 8. Pretty compact base. Don't think I was really going for... I was going for 3 stars, but didn't think I was going to get it. I mean, I still have level 4 hogs. Spoiler alert, not anymore, but in this war I do. So I grabbed the lure there with a lot of archers and wizards, so this is a fresh hit, first hit, and need to go ahead and bunch them up all in one big happy family so that they can all die a miserable death under a poisonous cloud, which they will right here. I don't think I got some of those archers, so let's throw another barbarian, there we go, and that'll go ahead and get everything but I think 2 of them. So, whatever, no big deal. They'll be taken out with my entry here. So, drop a shattered entry, my own golem, and a golem brought in from the clan castle, max golem, and then drop some my royals in there, take out that archer queen. Those wizards up top will take care of that enemy king picking on the golem. And then, don't think I brought any wall breakers, so it's time to jump them in there. So the max golem will go ahead and start tanking and going in for these defenses. The king will go ahead and jump in as well. Queen will take out that defense, and then she'll start making her way into the jump. And now it's just time to start sending in the hogs. Very, very compact base. Use the king abilities there. Still have 11 more hogs left over as some of these defenses are being tanked by the kill squad. 2 more heals left and 11 hogs still that I haven't deployed, just making their way surgically around the base. I'll just drop in the rest of them there, as again, this base is super, super compact. No real worries about double giant bomb spots, maybe a couple giant bomb spots here and there, but they'll go ahead and heal up there. Still have 1 more heal left over. I think both of my royals are still up. Then, look at this, Hero Pekka dropped in here for the pack and tanking. Let's go ahead and tank with the Pekka. Let those hogs keep going, make their way through. So that Pekka is not really doing her job. She's not tanking for anybody right now. There we go. She's tanking for the hogs with that archer tower there. And then the wizard will say, you know what? Let's go ahead and take care of that archer tower. And it's all over. So hogs will finish up that last defense up top. And then they will start to go ahead and do a cleanup. Don't think any golems are left. I could be mistaken, but it doesn't really matter. Pekka, she's cleaning up below. And Queen's shooting the storage. And then they'll all reconvene at the bottom storage and take that one out. So very nice attack, if I do say so myself, modestly and humbly. Okay, so If you didn't get enough of my first attack, the 6-star war for me, funky base here. This was actually my first attack. So I decided to, you know, it was not the easiest of lures. I mean, not a difficult one, but I wanted to send a giant in there to tank for those hogs, make sure they got all the way in there to grab that pesky lure. I just had a feeling, I think it was like 22 of 25 for the clan castle that they filled, so I knew, I was pretty sure it wasn't a dragon or anything, and I thought it was going to be something like this. So I wanted to make sure that my hogs made it all the way in there to grab that full lure, and, you know, didn't have any of the straggler wizards and, you know, anything else that could ruin my kill squad. So I'll drop it on the wizards. The wizards are the most important, and I think I pull, there we go, pull the rest of them in with that barbarian. So they're all be dead, and then we'll focus our way down here. And I think I brought just one golem. I think it's just doing a cold-blooded entry. That king will be dropped in there and do a queen-king swap or king-queen swap real quick. It will hit her a couple times and it will all be over. Hidden Tesla pops up and kind of destroys that funnel a little bit. We'll go ahead and take care of those wizards as well as that double giant. That giant bomb will do the same. Drop a heal in there and make them go all the way into the double compartments. And at this point, I think I've accomplished everything that I wanted to with the kill squad. So they're tanking for the hogs, so we might as well send them in another hidden Tesla. And I'll go ahead and start deploying the hogs from behind the kill squad, just because I feel like I let them tank a little bit. And I think the hogs to the right will just go be suicidal hogs at this point. Still have two more heals left and 9 more hogs to deploy. So we'll go ahead and send the rest of them in there. Again, a pretty compact base, so I can send a lot. I don't have to sprinkle my hogs in like a complete surgical because I'm not really worried about them tripping a double giant bomb spot. There you go. They trip one giant bomb, and they walk through a heal completely and are healed back up to full. The last heal, excuse me, very nice. And, yep, they only have to make it through that expo. There's like a billion hogs to do that. So they will go ahead and take care of that king. Pekka's in there hitting things and kind of with the king. And queen's still up. Everybody's still up. Everybody's having a good time. And everything is awesome. Everything is cool when you're part of a team. So there we go. 6-star war for me. Another 3-star attack using just the GoHo. Sen goes and takes this compact base with another GoHo. And not sure if it's shattered or cold-blooded. Let's take a look. I mean, their bases were very poor design, but what made them even worse is they kept putting these royals all the way in the outskirts, and I just don't understand that. It just makes no sense to me at all. I mean, literally, you can drop a giant in there and two wizards and take out each one of those royals like that. But go ahead and do an easy clan castle lure and kill those clan castle with poison. We'll go ahead and drop a couple giants in there, just like I said, and those wizards will aggro on that queen super fast, and will take her out in just a couple hits, or not. They will actually die to that mortar. So the Pekka will go in there and knock her down one time and basically just move on. Just do that little pimp smack and then just... she'll continue to go. So tons of wall breakers going in to get that second compartment open. They will trip a giant bomb, but they will also open that compartment up. It will not make it all the way to that last compartment, but they'll send the hogs, because you know what hogs can do? They can jump walls. So 3 more heals left over, 2 more now, 1 more after, or I'm sorry, 2 more left over after these 2 are used, as there was no jump spell brought. No need. Really low walls equal wall breakers. Uses that third heal, and pretty soon we'll use that fourth heal right up here for that left side group of hogs. There we go. And all the other hogs will come and bask in that glow. And they only have about 2 or 3 more defenses left. That archer tower is the only thing left. They will hit the giant bomb, but they'll be healed right back up to full again. And that king will try to take the Pekka on, is not always the smartest move. He'll learn the very hard way that you don't pick a fight with the Pekka. And the Pekka smacks him down, and she continues to move on, and everybody's cleaning up. trip that last giant bomb, and very nice attack. Alright, I'm going to skip Logan's attack, as that he's a Town Hall 8, so let's go ahead. I think that might be it. Alright, very nice. So that is our Town Hall 9 attacks. So we'll go ahead and end this video right here, and then we'll go ahead and put out another video with the Town Hall 8 attacks against this clan. So hopefully you were able to, you know, take those kind of attacks, at least the compositions, the deployment style and everything like that, and you know, what kind of spells to bring and when to use and all that kind of good stuff. And you know, go get your 6-star wars and your 3-star attacks.